Hey there, welcome back to another video, and in this video I'm gonna tell you what are the requirements for machine learning course. And in this video I'm gonna specifically talk about my machine learning course, but in general if you are learning if you are doing machine learning using Python, then you must be using these you must require these kind of libraries or whatever I'm gonna talk about. So let's get into it. So guys, the first thing that we need is a programming language, and I'm choosing Python for that because why not. And Python has a great library support, although it is very slow, not very slow basically, but it is slow. And but there are some libraries like NumPy that can increase its speed, so I'm gonna use Python. Okay, that is the first thing. Now the second thing is NumPy. Basically I'm gonna use NumPy for our matrix calculation because it is going to increase our speed very much. Okay, the third thing is Pandas library, and Pandas libraries will be helpful for us to get the data out of the files and read file and write file for things like that. Now if I talk about the fourth thing that we will need is the OpenCV, because I'm gonna make some projects that will be related to open computer vision basically, so I'm gonna use that. And the fifth thing that I'm gonna use is Matplotlib library, because we want to represent our data to normal people so that they can easily understand the data and our algorithm. So for that I'm gonna use Matplotlib, and I may be using seaborn sometimes, but if I'll use seaborn, then I will explain you what I'm doing, because I have created videos or tutorials for Matplotlib, OpenCV, and let's take Pandas and NumPy and even Python. So I have done all of that, so if you want to watch that, then please go and check in the description, you will find link for all of them. So guys, the last thing is maths, and if you do not want to get into maths, then it's perfectly okay, you can just use sklearn. But I will suggest that you should take a look at how machine learning algorithms works from the scratch, so that you can understand their implementation and you can have a better idea of how these things or these algorithms are working basically, and you can tune their hyperparameters so then they can improve or decrease, they can basically increase or decrease their accuracy or things like that. So if you will have a better idea, then you will have a greater control over the algorithm. So it is better to have the understanding of the machine learning algorithms from scratch. But I know that in real world even I don't use my own machine learning algorithms, because we have a library, so we do not have to waste any time for that. So guys, these are the things that we need, and specifically let me tell you about what you will need in math. So the first thing is linear algebra, and if you want to learn in about linear algebra in deep, then I will give you a link in the description, so you can check it out, and it is a free tutorial by MIT. So that is one of the best tutorial you can find on internet about linear algebra. But if you do not want to get in a lot of maths, then the minimum requirement is that you should check on internet that how operation works in matrix. Okay, so what is the dot product, what is the scalar product, and things like that. So this is about linear algebra. The next thing that we will need is calculus. Now calculus is a very big word, but for calculus, in calculus basically you only have to learn differentiation. So for calculus you can take a look at this course, and this course is very good, and I will provide a link in the description to go to that video and take a look at all the video. I think there are 11 or 12 videos. You will understand about differentiation, whatever you will need in basically machine learning, and that is a very good course, so you should check it out. And the last thing is probability and statistics. So in probability you can skip that for now, but there are some specific specific machine learning algorithms that uses probability for its base. Let's take naive bias. So that uses probability very much. So for those kind of algorithm you have to have some idea about what is probability and things like that. But this was it, and I hope that you understood what you will be needing for this machine learning course. So I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.